Our next story is from Ethiopia. It is the largest country in the Horn of Africa region, and its government is regularly at war with the people. At present, there are two major conflicts taking place, one in the Amhara region and the other in Oromia. The Oromia conflict is long drawn, but the latest phase has been raging since 2018, months after Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed took charge. And another event occurred around the same time. A clandestine security committee was formed. Their existence was kept a secret. Their goal was to try and end the Oromia conflict, but they have reportedly become a Gestapo-like squad, ordering illegal detentions and extrajudicial killings. Here's our report.
Ethiopia is a multicultural country, home to people of multiple different ethnicities. The largest group are the Oromo, native to the southern Oromia region of Ethiopia. The country's Prime Minister, Abiy Ahmed, is also a member of this group. But despite this, his government seems to have been targeting his brethren. After Abiy Ahmed took office in 2018, a secret committee was formed, called the Kori Naginya, meaning Security Committee in the Oromo language. This committee was formed to tackle the Oromo conflict, an insurgency that has been raging since at least 1973. It has taken various shapes and forms over the years, but the latest phase began in August 2018, months after Abiy Ahmed came to power. It seems that to counter this, the Ethiopian government formed the Kori Naginya. Now, a security committee may not sound out of place, especially considering the tenuous situation in Oromia. But this committee was kept a secret. Its existence was just confirmed last week by an investigative report. This investigation has brought disturbing details to light. It seems this committee has gone into Gestapo territory, ordering arbitrary detentions, torture, extortion, and even extrajudicial killings. This is according to the head of Ethiopia's Human Rights Commission. He also said the committee overreached its purpose by interfering in the justice system with widespread human rights violations. These violations allegedly include the massacre of 14 tribal leaders in 2021, a massacre later blamed on Oromia rebels. The so-called Security Committee was apparently formed months after Abiy Ahmed took charge. It is allegedly headed by the PM's former chief of staff. It meets in the Oromia regional offices of his Prosperity Party. But so far, there is still no concrete proof that Abiy Ahmed is behind its illegal activities, even though some people have alleged that it was formed at his instigation. If we believe that he has nothing to do with it, then it means that there was a rogue government agency murdering people under his watch. Or we assume that Abiy Ahmed was involved, which means Ethiopia's Nobel Peace Prize-winning PM has a murderous secret police force. Neither scenario is good for Abiy Ahmed, nor for Ethiopia. The country has been a hotbed for violence. The Oromia conflict is ongoing. There was the Tigray War that ended in 2022, and now there's a conflict in Ethiopia's Amhara region. Amhara is becoming another killing field. Last Monday, 15 civilians were reportedly killed in an airstrike. At least 45 others were killed last month, allegedly in door-to-door raids by federal security forces. Over 50 people were killed in December, and so on. This is in Amhara. We don't know yet if that region has its own so-called security committee too. If they do, there may be more atrocities waiting to be discovered.